Hi guys, welcome back to the DxO PhotoLab series. Now this video is going to deal with two of the local adjustment tools. We're going to be looking at graduated filters and control lines. Now we're all familiar with graduated filters, I hope. These started life as pieces of glass, smoked, that would be drawn across the lens to bring the sky down to the level of the land in terms of brightness. Now, the control line does much the same thing, but it has one added bonus, which is absolutely huge. There's a color picker attached, which you can drag to different parts of the image, which affect the intensity of the mask by sampling the color and tone of the area that you drop the color picker on. Now, what this does effectively is gives you immense flexibility because you can drag it to a dark area and the graduated filter will be applied in relation to that dark area or to a light area and vice versa, the same thing will happen. You also have sophisticated tools that will allow you to control the intensity of the mask so that it's possible to get very, very precise positioning of your mask in your picture. And I'm going to show you how to do this. Let's get on with it. Okay, I thought it'd be useful to look at the problem that graduated filters and control lines seek to resolve. So, in this rather ordinary landscape photograph, we've exposed for the sky. We've got a little bit of detail up here. It's not terribly interesting, but it is what it is. The sky is well exposed. We've got detail in the middle background, which you probably would want to keep, but we've got rather too much darkness in the foreground, except for this area here. So we've got a lot of darks, well exposed, perhaps a little too bright. Now, if we go to the light module, we can see exactly how tricky this is to resolve, because if I increase the exposure to the point where I can see my detail in these rocks, the sky gets blown out and I'm not getting exactly the result I want. So this light area here is becoming very prominent indeed, and that is really dragging your eye to the bottom left hand corner, and that is absolutely not what we want to do. So simply altering the exposure is not going to help. Let's have a look and see what we might do with the graduated filter. Now, it's a local adjustment, and that means that the changes are applied simply to the bounds of the mask that we apply. So if we choose grad filter and pull it down from the top to more or less the horizon, okay. If we turn on the black and white mask, you can instantly see the problem. That mask is covering the mountains, and it's going to make what is dark even darker when I drop the exposure. So let's just check that that's the case. Okay, so you can clearly see tops of these mountains moving towards black. Absolutely not a solution. Now, I can look in here and I can perhaps invert the mask. So now I'm getting to brighten the bottom without affecting the sky, but it's still not really working with the tops of these mountains. They're not effectively covered. So close, but not really a very good solution. Turn that off. Let's get rid of the graduated filter. And let's have a look at control lines. Now, control lines are come much closer to resolving this problem. Let's put a new control line in, and we'll put it in the same place. And you can see the mask immediately is kind of gentler. We bring that down to around about there. It's still covering the mountains, but we've got a little trick up our sleeve, this dropper. Because if we drop the dropper here in the sky, then this is not going to particularly affect the tops of the mountains. So drop that down. And you can see the sky getting darker if you look particularly at this area here, which was the one that was getting very, very dark before. That's really not going. And we can take this down quite a long way. Now, if I, just to make the point, move this dropper into the mountain, let's have a look at the black and white version of this mask. So we'll show the mask, and you can see immediately what we've done is we've selected the darks, and so you've got a much stronger application of the mask here than you have in the sky. And let's just show that in the black and white mask. This is now completely obvious. Any change here will be applied to the mountains and not to the sky so much. Okay, so that's one trick. Take that back to the sky and get to the solution that we want. Now, the other thing that we can do, let's just turn off this black and white mask, is we can apply negative control lines as well, and this will just help us tidy up a little bit. So if we drag this down a bit more, so get closer to the tops of those hills, then we might want to protect this area here and this area here. And let's see how we would do that. We leave the same control line, but we do a negative version. And what this is about is simply protecting certain areas. I'll do this the other way, just to show the difference. So the one on the left comes from the top down, so the negativity, if you like, will be more pronounced here. This one from the bottom up, negativity, be down here. And let's have a look and see how that works in life. So take that down. You can see that the mountain on the left is now virtually untouched. Now, what you can see also is a little bit of white banding showing up, and so this is not perfect by any means, but it's a lot more perfect than the graduated filter. Now, there are other tools that would make this a lot easier. We could simply drag that down a little bit. That would get rid of the banding. And it's really a subjective view as to how much we can live with. So this is fine, I think, on the particularly on that left-hand side. Let's turn out the masks. All right, so we can see now the banding is gone. The mask is preserved, if you like, in the sky, but it's not applied in this rock at all. Now, there are more complex scenarios than this, and we might want to use other local adjustments to really finesse this, but this is an example of the typical problem that landscape photographers look to solve. And for me, control lines are the answer. I've taken to using control lines to resolve this problem in all of my landscape shots now. I barely use graduated filters at all. Now, I think we've demonstrated pretty much everything. We've looked at the graduated filter. We've looked at how to reverse the grad filter. We've looked at control lines. We've looked at how we can apply that control line to the light area in the sky or to the dark area that it also covers. We've looked at how we can negate the effect of that control line by dragging another control line. We've looked at the danger area that that shows up, which is the danger of having a little bit of banding around your outline there. And I think that pretty much concludes it. I think you'll find control lines very, very useful, and I would urge you to use control lines probably rather than grad filters. The only time I would still probably use a grad filter is if I was doing a seascape and I've got a real sharp level band between my sky and my rocks. But this is more typical of real life. You've always got something cropping up that prevents that entire grad filter solution from working properly. So thanks for bearing with me. This concludes our look at control lines and grad filters. Thank you.